And now, enjoy a performance of Pretty Blonde the Musical Junior from Spark of Creation Studio!
Unqualified, but she didn't even bother turning in a personal essay.
How's this for a personal essay?
What you want? What you want?
Security!
What you want?
Inspires everyone, admires her, and Harper should too.
This is events, I still can't find one reason to admit you.
How about love? Because if you have no love, but love never accepts a defeat. No challenge you can't meet, no place you cannot go.
Alibi.
I can't because I gave Brooke my word. Having an alibi isn't the only only way to win this case.
Yeah, but it would sure help.
Paulette, I came to say goodbye.
What? Goodbye?
I'm going back home to California.
California? Why?
Going back to where I make sense.
I'm not making any right now. Honey, what happened?
All this time, I thought I was proving myself and making a difference. But I'm just one big blonde joke. That's all anyone's ever gonna see.
Just make him do it again. hysterical. So, and it's a two-person bit, and it just, I mean, hysterical. So we've been talking, here's what I'll say. We've been talking a lot today about, Stephen talked earlier about having an internal metronome, and that when we get in this environment of JTF, we get excited, and there's things that happen, and sometimes the music isn't, the tempo of the music doesn't match the energy that we have to sell it, and we sometimes rush. But when we got to the What You Want section, the Jamaica Me Crazy, Spring Bash Extreme section, that is a place where I've seen Legally Blonde and Adjudication where that internal metronome can fall away and we can get ahead. And you were so sunk into your internal rhythm and that internal metronome. It was locked in, and then when the two parts happened, the love, we're doing this for love part came in, like it all just like stayed perfectly in sync and made that so rewarding. What show are you doing tonight?
Nemo.
Nemo. Okay, they're a showcase group. They're showcasing Finding Nemo tonight. I'm done. I've taught you nothing. I've taught you nothing. Who's going next?
I'll try. I'll try. That's the key word. Another key word that I want to say is trust. You guys, like, I trusted. I obviously did not write anything down except for Legally Blonde. I just sat and watched because I trusted all of you guys, because I could just feel that you were like in it, you knew what you were doing, you led this group perfectly. Your voice. Then they were like sprinkles of like other characters who just like wailed.
Musicals were black and white, that's when I did them, so it was a long time ago, but you hit those musical accents so beautifully, and that's on you. It means you were listening to the music. It means that all of those bells and whistles that were recorded in Nashville are being translated by young people telling us that story. So that's the first thing I had. I had the Delta News just heard it. All those boom, boom, you know, it's so exciting, it's so much fun. Pepperina jokes, it's subtle, brilliant, great timing, good timing, love it. I love the pacing. Yeah, your pacing throughout the payment piece was really great. I kind of brought that up with another group earlier about pacing, and I thought, I never worried about you running out of steam. Because the show, once it starts, I think it's that little, moment with the UPS to Brandon. That's the time you're going to almost breathe, right, in the show. So your pacing was really delightful. Everywhere I watched, and Derek mentioned this earlier, that we like to look at the people that don't think they're being looked at. And we are. And everywhere I looked, I noticed engaged choreography, music, everything that was supposed to be done. It didn't matter where you were, that I really, really It's impressive. There's a reason there's all of you on stage, because we need each and every one of you to tell this story right now, and that's what you did. One thing that I would love to use as an example here is, could you get to that spot where, right before, it's a semicircle before Jamaica Be Crazy. And there is small group down here talking, are you talking yet? And you guys are all kind of, you're like in a foggy focus, is that true? Yeah, could you just give me a starting point there? Do you know where we are? I think it's dialogue. And everybody go, and you're on stage in front of the Obamas. Good, 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 good. That was good, right? It was really good. It was really good. One exercise you can use in that little actor's toolbox, again, take something, put it in there, use it for the others. When you're back in soft, in a soft lens with Vaseline on the camera. Practice, rehearse, say it. Everything you're saying right now, I want to hear it. I want to hear just you guys. Oh my gosh, your hair is fantastic. Okay, can we do that scene again? That level of voice is just fine. Here we go, I want to hear all of your conversations. Go. Different energy?
Yes.
It's because you were actually having a conversation instead of going, easy carrots, easy carrots. Right? Now, take it down to about half of that. Same energy physically, but now instead of talking as loud as Stephen Kennedy, I need you to talk like a normal person. Here we go. And hit it. Awesome. Now can we go back? Good, still good energy. I want that energy to keep going. Yeah, as you get quieter, I want your bodies to get more energy, give more energy. Here we go, complete silence. Now it is just lipping, lip syncing, or whatever that is. Here we go, and hit it.
And you've got a lot of work in front of you.
Yeah. So automatically, just that little trick, it takes 2.3 seconds to just kind of, yeah. Very nice, yes. Had you not done that, I would have had egg on my face, so thank you. No. But it just takes that little extra work to find that dialogue, and that is what's going to help you find your character throughout the show anyway. Yeah? Really, really special. That was really lovely tonight. Can we also wish them luck tonight in the audience?